How do we make someone come to life? And when do they leave the room as a fact of history and re-enter as a real person? Maybe it's when we connect with their heart, the essence of their passion. It makes friends with something inside of us. This montage is a simple collection. It's like a mere blink of an idea about who Paulo Freire may have been. Only you can make him come to life for you. Was he a giant? Or do you look at these clips and see a person who is able to recognize the sacred and the genius in the marginalized, whose passion and rage and creativity caused him to see truths and speak them, and even more so, act them out, even to the point of exile?
Moço, muito jovem, eu fui aos mangues do Recife, aos córregos do Recife, aos morros do Recife, às zonas rurais de Pernambuco, trabalhar com os camponeses, com as camponesas, com os favelados.
What makes Paulo Freire a giant in the world of philosophy, social justice, and education? It's probably his ability to awaken our own sleeping giants, those big realizations we have inside ourselves that move us to do the right thing for others. Deposits of information about Paulo Freire have been made in my brain. I've read articles about Paulo, chapters from his literary activism, the pedagogy of the oppressed, and the pedagogy of hope. I'll always know about him. I've committed it to my memory, his great contribution to the areas of critical thinking, the huge shift in the teacher-student concept and that relationship, the interesting concept of problem posing, making it real, so to speak, and the teachers as cultural workers. Yet I start to go beyond knowing about the man to seeing him come to life. When I begin to relate to many of his beliefs, such as the idea that people develop their power to perceive critically the way they exist in the world, with which and in which they find themselves. Paulo Freire may be a giant for the work he did to wake the giant in others.
Não foram os camponeses que disseram a mim, Paulo, tu já leste Marx? Não, de jeito nenhum, eles não liam nem jornal. Foi a realidade deles que me remeteu a Marx. E eu fui a Marx. E aí é que os jornalistas europeus, em 70, não entenderam a minha afirmação. É que quanto mais eu li Marx, e tanto mais eu encontrei uma certa fundamentação objetiva para continuar camarada de Cristo. Então, as leituras que eu fiz de Marx, de alongamentos de Marx, não me sugeriram jamais que eu deixasse de encontrar Cristo na esquina das próprias favelas. Eu fiquei com Marx na mundanidade à procura de Cristo na transcendência.
What I'm most intrigued by is an understanding of his heart, because in my world it is the heart that informs the mind, which creates a dialogue. Dialogue can incite action, and with action comes change. Lifting the dark rock of oppression is the work of giants who know that beneath it lie the seeds of change. I think Paulo had a giant heart. So if we're going to wonder about something, if we are going to be able to relate to something about this giant, let's wonder about what was in his heart. What moved him to love and to put his rage into action? And then wonder again, what would Paulo learn from you?